IVM. कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, द लैंग्वेज यूज ऑन द पॉडकास्ट मे नॉट बी फिट फॉर कंजम्पशन. वी वॉर्न यू, ट्रेड केयरफुली. बट लिसन यार, डोंट बी सो कंजर्वेटिव. ऑलराइट, वी हियर विद साइरस सेज इंटरेस्टिंग यंग मेन ऑन द शो. Oh, that sounds like an ad for homosexual dating in 2020. I apologize. But before we get into that, we want to quickly talk about the fact that I'm amazed that we are sending to Australia in end November a team of 50 plus people, 32 players to play the cricket series and over 20 officials with them. Because of this catastrophe that we have called epidemic, etc., they are taking reserves in case people get injured or die in the middle of for whatever reason. I just want to clearly say that this is not a team. This is what animals call a migration. You can't send 55 people from India to Australia just to play cricket. It's just ridiculous.
रिश्ते में तो हम तुम्हारे पॉडकास्ट लगते हैं. नाम है फुटबॉल शुड बॉल.
Presenting Football Should Ball, a show about three friends discussing our favorite game over a beer, sometimes three, maybe even five. Hi, I'm Shiva, and with me are my two sidekicks, Gaurav Sapre and Kartik Iyer.
Sidekick? You mean like Batman's Robin or Van Persie Robin?
No, I mean like Alexis Sanchez, but with a little more skill than just playing the piano.
Ha, just shows how the best players at Arsenal are mere bench warmers at United.
Oh, thank you, Iyer, but you're a Fulham supporter, so whenever you say anything to support me, I question my beliefs.
Just like how Griezmann would say, एक बार मैंने जो decision ले लिया, तो मैं अपने आप की भी नहीं सुनता.
Banter aside, we will talk match reports, transfer rumors, top controversies, fantasy football picks, and so much more. So grab a beer and tune in to Football Should Ball every Wednesday on the IVM podcast app, website, or wherever you get your podcasts.
All right. That being said, it's time to get into the more serious and beautiful lives of people who invest in food and have lots of other talents as well. Two young men making names. I think this is the one subject which has survived. You have to feed yourself during pandemic. So it's the one subject which, of course, everybody has turned to. And food has actually grown. And GDP may collapse, but we are still thinking about food, rightly or wrongly. So let's welcome, first and foremost, the show that they are going to do is called Naan Curry. Naan Curry sounds Japanese, Naan Curry, but it's not. It's actually Naan and Curry, which I personally don't think go together, but we'll discuss that. The names of our guests, Sadaf Hussain and Archit Puri. Now, a quick word on Sadaf. How much time should I give you all in description, yaar? Aap batao. 30 seconds?
Yeah, that's more.
Because
than
the fucking biodata is like 66 minutes each, which is a separate podcast. I mean, that was Archit to come back for his, because it's like... Okay, let's quickly say. Sadaf is chief and author of Dastani Dastarkhan. I hope I said that correctly. And currently working on his next book. I'm saying my next book. So much research I've done. On his next books on food memories. He was one of the top MasterChef India contestants in 2016. Where I've heard that everything is rigged. So you should have won it. But you know how it is.
We don't talk about that.
No. Also, there... And also, Sadaf, you know all kinds of theories in India, no? At the moment. Yeah. You have to be born in a certain way to win. No.
I know. Sure.
Before going to the show, you used to run Delhi's first pop cafe. Pop cafe ka matlab kya hai? We'll figure that out also. I'm not quite sure. It was called Bread and Butter with Bread and Better, with the idea to cook live with fresh ingredients for people who are looking for a break from the usual. Acha, so you used to cook live, which is a great thing. I have worked with more than 15 restaurants. Not I, you, Yuga, Sara, you have, Sara, interrupt me. You have worked with more than 15 restaurants. And your website is foodandstreets.com. Is that right?
Yes.
Foodandstreets.com. You can check him out. His interests are in Indian cooking, obviously, but everything else as well. With a modern twist, he also promotes healthy eating. So, kamar ka size kya hai?
35 and a half.
That we'll never know also. Na? Kuch bhi bol sakta. His medium, this is the beauty of this medium. Only neck upwards is important. If both your balls have gone also, who cares? No one will know.
See, I was very precise. 35 and a half.
That doesn't mean it's correct, yaar.
Yeah. Nobody will say you're wrong if you say
Arichad, a precise statement. You know those guys in your group when we are drinking alcohol in college and all that, and they look at the girls and start giving them ratings? I mean, the ugliest guy will say, ah, ye toh theek nahi hai, yaar. Aage se theek nahi hai, yaar. You know, and I'm like, hey, look at you, yaar. How can you even say that? Chalo, 35.5 ho gaya. And you're writing, cooking on restaurants. You have host shows all over. You contribute to NDTV's food website as a food expert, and you take food. And they were one channel who really pushed food right from the beginning. yeah. before their agenda is going to courts to protect themselves from certain parties.
Yes.
let's stay on food. okay, let's move now to Arichit, who writes and research on behavioral science, economics and technological strategy. If I was a woman, I would not even date him. This is amongst the most boring sentences in the English language. Kaise batao? Behavioral science, economics and technology strategy. Ah, yeah, lovely. His essays have been published in Mint, Hindustan Times and Pragati, even though he suspects they're only read by his parents and one kind friend.
Yeah.
Which is possibly Sadaf.
Huh? Yeah. Possibly. Yeah. I hope so, Sadaf.
Richie's reverse psychology comes next. Since writing doesn't pay enough, so what he's saying is that he's Premchand and should be paid 10,000 million rupees. And unfortunately, they're not saluting him enough. So he has to turn to normal stuff. And he actually has a day job, which is what exactly?
I make PPTs and Word documents. And I use words like strategy, synergy, growth, markets in them, you know.
I'm getting an erection, boss. It's just beautiful. Yeah. just listening is lovely. But the main thing, the reason why you're here is that you criticize people who use the word foodie. I have a friend who uses the word foodie as like what, down market or less sophisticated in food. And you like to use the word, how do you pronounce it? Gourmand. It sounds like a road outside Gurgaon only.
Yeah.
अरे यहाँ से जाओ गुरमा आ गया.
गुरमा.
It's Gourmand.
कौन से गुरमांड लेना?
See, I'm with the North Indian boys now. See, everything has ma in it. Gurma ki jai. Cool.
Hey, Bombay has teri ma ka saki ma ka.
Bombay has destroyed bad language. All the boys who speak good Hindi and come here, they're gali stained. So when they go back to the North and fight, the other guy is confused. Because the genders are all mixed up and the ki and the ka goes anywhere. We can say teri ma ki, teri ma ka. It's all acceptable. You don't worry. Of course, it'll take a real chuth who'll stop to discuss the grammar while the fight is going on.
Exactly. Like, wait a second. Let me correct.
Actually,
इसमें कहाँ नहीं की होना चाहिए.
अबे दोबारा. And go. अरे बाबा, now I've lost your thing. Now you have to give me a minute to find it again. Arichit, you tell me more now while I search. What is this gurma? Huh? That the gurma intellectual use for foodie. So what is that exactly?
It just means somebody who really likes to think, talk, eat. And, you know, the term foodie has been overused. Every second person's Instagram page says foodie. So, you know, now that we're starting a podcast, thoda to stand out karna chahiye na. To
I agree with you. I think this foodie ka, everyone, you know, forget in podcasts or whatever you're doing. You all are both in the business. So it's a little different. But just normal conversation mein log aisa kehte hai always. Hey, are you a foodie? Which is like, firstly, what does that mean? Everybody must be a foodie because there's something everybody likes. So this is a ridiculous question. I mean, I can't understand if you're actually, you know, anyone who doesn't like some food at least, some particular food.
No one.
No.
Do you blame your friend Kunal Vijaykar for this?
He's a chooth. Complete fat fuck useless guy. Couldn't think of anything. Foodie theek hai. That's it. I think in those days nobody bothered. They just thought foodie was a cool word. Yeah. A cool word of the 90s becomes a useless word now. Yeah. When we were growing up, we used to use phrases like butchered and all that. Now if I say butchered, my son would kill me. He'd be like, please get out of the house. Nobody talks like that. I mean, you guys are also shocked because you've never heard these words either.
No, we were learning back then new words and then we got evolved. So nobody's like, no. What is the new word for butchered?
But Delhi slang mein ye important nahi hai. Jaante ho mera baap kaun hai? You know, you have to have all the VIP influential galis. Isn't that?
अलग लेवल का जाता है गालियां.
Exactly. होम मिनिस्टर, रिसर्च मिनिस्टर, उसके ऊपर कौन है, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ सम अदर कंट्री. लेट्स गेट बैक टू व्हाट वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर, व्हिच इज दिस वंडरफुल इंटरेस्ट इन फूड. सो सदाफ, यू आर द फॉर्मल गाय, एज इन यू आर द ट्रेन शेफ.
आई एम नॉट द ट्रेन शेफ, इन फैक्ट
यू आर एन अनट्रेन शेफ.
आई एम अनट्रेन शेफ, आई एम अ बस शेफ, नॉट अ ट्रेन शेफ.
व्हाट इज अ बस शेफ?
लाइक आई एम नॉट ट्रेन, आई एम बस. सॉरी, बैड जोक.
व्हाट द हेल. I might now go back to the central government and accept their rulings. This is ridiculous behavior. So Arichit, just explain to me before you talk about the podcast exactly. So you worked, no, Sadaf, you worked in restaurants and all that.
I worked in restaurants. So I said that I am not a trained chef because I was interested in food, and that's how the journey started. Bachpan mein, when I wanted to become a chef, my father said, "Nee, nee, nee, aise kaise? Ghar ka bachcha bawalji banega. Ye din aa gaye."
I tell you, parents are so motivating here.
And then the entire MasterChef thing started happening in 2010, and then then cooking suddenly became a really cool thing to do. So in 2016, I was like, okay, let me do MasterChef audition. So that's how I got interested.
But I thought MasterChef audition mein sirf actual chefs take part.
Nahi.
Oh.
The home chefs go. I mean, the home chefs and people who are interested in food, who can cook food, at least boil an egg, then they can participate in the show. So that's how my food journey started.
But before you went to MasterChef, were you like known to be a good cook in the locality or amongst the friends or family?
Yeah. So the pop-up that you talked about called Blood and Better. So I was with a friend of mine called Manasi. So Manasi and I was running pop-up cafes in Delhi.
Manasi, wo jaldi mein aa gaya, name. There's something more to this story. Yaar. When people just throw the name at you and keep walking, I suspect giving, something.
Giving credits to people. So we were running a pop-up cafe in Delhi, and we did for 1.5 years before I went to MasterChef. And that's how sort of the entire ye jo energy jo boost hui aur morale jo boost hua ki ha ha nahi nahi main bhi bana sakta hu. So that's the entire journey of food. And
so before you went to MasterChef, this was definitely what you were going to do anyway, because you had started the pop-up and all this.
No, pop-up was very like a time pass thing, side maker. I was into economics, so Archit and I were working in the same place as well. So I was economics and I was into public policy. I'll teach public policy. In fact, Archit attended one of the workshops which I was taking class. So yeah, that's how Archit and I met.
So you taught Archit and both of you realized that this is fuck all.
Yeah, so I'm fuck all. I can't do it. Let Archit do the economic bit.
So Archit saved you. He said, Guruji, aapke paas kuch hai nahi. Let's move, find something else. This is not working.
Exactly. Like, you stick to your food. Like, ye aap kar lijiye, main khana banata hu.
Main pakata hu, aap logo ke liye pakao.
So that's how we sort of found our niche.
Yeah. This is just a fancy story. Sadaf ki asli story that too many people were self-inviting themselves to Sadaf's house during Eid for biryani.
So Sadaf, you got a reputation of being a good cook.
No. He just wanted to, you know, learn cooking so that his mom does not have to cook all the biryani. So just to take the load off her, he learned to become a chef.
Hey, biryani is a very touchy subject, Yara. Sadaf, you better be good. I'm one of those guys, we have wars over biryanis, like which ones we like and which ones we don't like. And also, it's like racism. Like if the biryani doesn't actually have a biryani qualification, a lot of people say biryani hai, just because the rice is slightly colored.
What's your favorite, Cyrus?
See, first rule of life for us, and this comes from your foodie friend as well, is if there's no mutton in the biryani, I throw it out. Okay, it's not a biryani if it's chicken, it's not if it's egg, if it's not, and vegetarian, so I strangle the girl, guy. I'm like, what are you saying? You know, it's like going to a pond and the people are wearing clothes. Man, sure, I'm just spending all that money. So that's the first law, mutton. Then I don't know, we are very influenced by the masala style of Mumbai, which has also come from UP in a sense, with the Jaffar Bhai and all the legacies of that we have here. But it's evolved while coming to Mumbai. And so we like that undertone of masala, which is there. So I don't like raita with it. I don't like any wetness with it. I would like it dry. Oh, masala ke saath and the mutton, taza mutton ke saath, you get the effect. And the, if I may say so, the rice color is more yellow than white or anything else, which is also, I think, the way we like it. But it's a touchy subject.
It is. That's how I think my family also makes it. But we do pair it up with raita. Meri mummy ka kehna hai ki agar raita nahi khaya biryani ke saath mein, to phir properly biryani nahi khaya apne.
No, I can't say anything. We can't argue with the mother's wisdom. So ho gaya.
Exactly. Mummy to side mein rehte hain. But so biryani is a touchy topic, in fact. And I remember recently, main Patna mein apne book ke pre-pandemic, November last year, I was doing book launch and pop-up in a cafe. And wahan pe biryani I was serving. And so my relatives also came, because I have a bunch of people in Patna. And they came and they were like, oh, this is so amazing. And they called my mother saying, oh, Sadaf ne to kya biryani khilai di. And to koi agar meri biryani ki tareef karta to matlab 56 inch ka seena ho jata hai.
I think so. Nice reference, bita. Nice reference. I thought this was going to remain apolitical. But theek hai, we can jump from biryani to chaos in 1 second. But tell me one thing, jo biryani jo aapne banate, is it more of the mother's biryani or is it another biryani that you have made?
So this is influenced, of course, mother's biryani. Lekin I would say mother influence, kyunki hame thoda masala zyada pasand hai, jaise wo Bombay ya fir Hyderabad ka jo masala aata hai, waisa. Delhi biryani I completely do not like. Delhi as in jo Muradabadi biryani, which is bahut simple, which is like pulav.
Correct, yaar. I'm glad you brought this up. Again, not to be racist about it, but you know, when it becomes more pulav than biryani, I like pulav, but that's with the dal and you need other things with it.
Correct.
Yeah,
correct.
You need the salon with it.
All that. Yeah.
So that's what the biryani is for us. Haldu se banjata, in fact, hamare ghar pe to.
But you are now number one in the house? Because that is a huge thing. If agar aapki tarif karte log, and because the people you're talking about are the ones who eat it regularly. Forget the outsiders. Outsiders who don't eat biryani will say great for most things.
So, of course, mummy aur mere mein ladai chalta tha, kaun acha banata hai. We have not been able to figure it out. But I think we both have our days. So there's one unique thing that I make which my mother doesn't. And because jab maine banana khana start kiya, to maine ek cheez life mein rakha tha ki main wo khana nahi banaunga which my mother can make. Like, kya fayda hai? Mother is making the food, same food, to main kyun banaun?
Saram ki baat hai, Sadaf. I want to stop the podcast. What kind of like middle-aged guy is competing with his own mother? I mean, what is this here, really?
No, not
what
competing.
Has the country come to?
Not competing, just dividing. Ki, ye wala khana aap acha bana, to you focus on that. Ye khana main develop karta hu. So one kind of biryani which I make is kachche gosht ki biryani, which is a Hyderabadi version. Jisme you make like gosht basically kachcha.
Mutton separate?
Gosht. No, kachcha. So you're not cooking the mutton. You're just marinating it for 8-10 hours, and then you're cooking rice and mutton together. So in the same format, but it's because marinated ho gaya 8-10 ghanta tak papitiye mein dal ke, to wo easily saath mein cook ho jata hai. And that's the science and beauty about that particular kachche gosht ki biryani. So that is my favorite. And
I'm feeling hungry already. We should have these conversations. Long time for lunch, what I can see.
I know, Arichit,
we need to talk about you now a little bit. Sadaf is dominating the conversation with bloody biryani stories, yaar, and destroying his own family in the process. So what about you? Are you a cook of any kind?
I'm a casual cook. I mean, I make pasta at home. I can assist my mother.
Yeah, and aapka self-deprecating style, I don't understand whether it's true or not. Now, you have to tell us honestly because we have only so much time. Do you cook or not? I'm a casual cook. Then you find out the baga has some 35 restaurants and 15 awards. Huh?
Honestly, I cook. But why I'm getting into this podcast is not because I cook. Because I talk a lot about food. You know, over lunch conversations and dinner conversations, I bore people around me with random food facts. And, you know,
So now?
जैसे आपको मैं बताता हूँ चाय इंडिया में कैसे ओरिजिनेट हुई. द ब्रिटिशर्स एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड टी ब्रेक इन PSUs इन इंडिया जस्ट टू प्रमोट देयर ओन चाय. एंड चाय वालास इन टी स्टॉल्स थॉट कि वो चाय बहुत महंगी है, चाय पत्ती बहुत महंगी है, तो उसको हम 2-3 बार यूज कर सकते हैं. बट 2-3 बार यूज करने के लिए उसका फ्लेवर थोड़ा कम हो जाता है. सो when the flavor goes down, how do you compensate for it? So you introduce masala into it, you introduce ginger, cardamom, milk.
What are you saying?
Yeah.
Because it was a dirty old product.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yaar.
You introduce sugar, you introduce milk, and you sort of bastardize the British tea. And
the Indians are too good. Huh? We can take any system and just change it completely.
Yeah.
You see, cricket, England can't recognize cricket now. Look at what we've done.
Huh. Yeah, now you know, Starbucks also sells masala chai tea. So,
wow. So how do you know these facts, bud? Are you just you masturbate a lot? Because that's the type of guy who generally, you know, whole day pe internet pe. Huh?
No, I don't. I just like.
He put
stuff.
His hand up, huh? Sadaf, I don't know if it's a visual podcast hai ya nahi, but he put his hand up. We hope you're not doing anything now, yaar. Because then you're coming to biryani, which is like a really sad story.
I will do the podcast like this with my hands up.
How only hands up.
How would we know that there's nothing happening down there?
Exactly.
Arre, toh aur kya, pair se karunga kya?
Or in the words of Gabbar Singh, kitne aadmi the? Okay, back. Let's segue back.
So, I think, Cyrus, you mentioned in one of your podcasts that you don't like to talk about cricket or watch cricket with people who don't share your passion for it.
Racist. It's a racist thing. I hate people who pretend to like.
Yeah.
I mean, why do they pretend to like you? Because you can catch them very fast when they're talking, you know. Huh.
Yeah.
So, you are saying?
I have the same feeling about food and I would like to say cricket, but now I'm scared that you'll, you know, take out my case.
India ka caste system, shining bright.
Yeah.
Don't get into that territory. Stick to yours.
Yeah.
Listen, you guys have mentioned chai wala 4 times. I just want to tell you. Huh? Just think about it.
Our first episode is on chai.
Not promoting anybody.
But we accept all kind of sponsorship, so...
You think?
Yeah.
With the sponsorship comes a change in culture. Just think about it. First to go will be my mutton biryani. Believe me.
Puri ki puri chai badal jayegi.
We'll only get masala. No, nothing else. Let's get back to your thing. Sorry.
So then I found somebody who actually shares the same passion and that's Sadaf.
So for food. So if people talk food with you, you get irritated?
No, they get irritated.
because of the facts that keep coming out.
Yes, yes.
And, Saraf, are you okay with his attitude when he tells you some boring fact which makes no sense or no consequence?
सुनना
पड़ता है ना, साथ में रिकॉर्ड करना है पॉडकास्ट में, तो हाँ ओके बदास जो दैट मूवी ना सह लेंगे थोड़ा तो सह लेते हैं.
It's business. Yeah, but it's good, no? One guy is like a statistician and what is it, gourmand or whatever it is. And yeah. You're like the guy who's in the kitchen. Although he claims he can cook. Can he cook, Saraf?
He claims that. Haven't tasted his food yet.
What are you saying? Ye kaisa dosti hai? One-way traffic.
One-way traffic. Ye ek tarfa mohabbat.
Yes.
Saraf also cooks only for YouTube audiences, yaar. हमारे लिए नहीं बनाया कभी सदा.
अच्छा, द क्रैक्स इन द फ्रेंडशिप. ठीक है भाई, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम द ऑपोजिशन इज हैविंग, दे कैन नॉट कम टुगेदर, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम.
हेलो, वी हैव टू गेट आवर एक्ट टुगेदर.
No, but what does he cook? Arijit, what do you cook? What's like, he's famous for, let's say, biryani and a few other dishes from the Indian cuisine style. What about you?
I can make ran at home.
Wow.
Yeah. I assist my mother while she makes mutton curry, which is actually one of my favorite things to eat.
Spicy,
प्याज टमाटर के साथ, but yeah, very spicy.
That's part of the secularism of India. We put प्याज and tomato in everything.
Absolutely.
But Saraf, what do you think? Ran is also, it looks like a simple dish, but I've eaten it all over because, you know, we are hardcore red meat eaters, sadly.
Yeah.
Although we love animals, it's not very often. It just like biryani. It seems simple, but it's just not good enough. Like here we like Shalimar, for example, which is world famous in Mumbai.
Yeah.
And I'm sure in Delhi there are a couple of places. So why is there a difference in these dishes which appear simple?
So in fact, last Bakhrid, I was like, and I have started this tradition. Every Bakhrid, I will cook adhan. And it takes time. It takes like to marinate the whole adhan, which is like a 2.5 kg if you're talking about a goat or a mutton adhan, 2.5 or 3 kgs adhan. And it takes like 8-10 hours of marination and cooking further. And ab ke zamane mein, in fact, so we have got this electric griller, ya fir mostly electric griller pe aise flaton mein kahan par hai wo haveliyon wali baat, aur ya fir tandoor wali. So if you go into Karim's and all, usme dala bilkul tandoor ran mein.
Yeah, Ashok Hotel na jahan pe murder bhi hua,
yeah,
in the tandoor.
Yes.
To Arjit is too young, he doesn't understand yet.
And that's why I think, and also the flavor wise, because alag alag jagahon ka, like for example, Maharashtra will have a lot more spicier food, have like a little bit of Kolhapur influence, right? Versus Delhi, which will be spicy but also greasy. But that's the Delhi version. And I think state wise, kis tarike ka logo ka khana pasand hai. And it could also be like if you're talking about a very jungly way, which is a tribal way of making ran, that will be like a very basic, simple masala, which is, let's say, प्याज टमाटर मिर्ची डाल के उसको मैरिनेट करके एंड देन लीव इट ओपन.
इसमें एक ही चीज है, मसाला. अल्टीमेटली आई मीन लीव असाइड सपोजिंग द मीट इज द सेम लेवल, इट्स जस्ट अ मसाला. यू लिव एंड डाई ऑन दैट, द टेस्ट.
Correct. I think masala, like my brother, for example, when he cooks in the kitchen, he's like, ki, acha, kya bana de aaj? Kadai chicken. Kyun? Kyunki hum chicken ko kadai bana de. Isliye, it is called kadai chicken. And then, whatever kind of masala, irrespective, whatever, like, for example, agar nihari masala pada hua hai, ya fir kholma masala pada hai, it doesn't matter. Just add that. Everything will taste same because masala changes the flavor of the entire dish. So, yeah, and even for example, chicken, right? Chicken has no flavor in it, but
no flavor.
You basically add flavor in the masala itself, and that sort of gives you the different flavor.
It's also about how much heat you add to it and how long you add it for. So,
yeah.
So I think most Indian food historically has been based on slow cooking. So, even the ran has to be slow cooked, otherwise, maza nahi aata.
Correct.
Slow cooking because of our philosophy of, you know, take time. Lots of time, there's nothing to do while the pandemic is on, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But you guys are critics also? Arjit, you're a critic? As in, you look at, you eat food and you want to comment about it publicly?
Absolutely. Not publicly, but privately around people who I irritate, who I'm having lunch with usually, but not publicly.
Give me your top 5 worst experiences anywhere. If you don't want to use names, that's fine. But just tell us the dish.
So I actually saw somebody on YouTube, I haven't eaten this thankfully, making butter chicken with coconut milk, a vegan butter chicken. Vegan matlab chicken hai usme, but the gravy is...
Iska matlab kya hai? Jain chicken and all? I've never understood this. What the hell does it mean?
Yeah, it's strange.
So what does it mean?
So
Jain, can my Jain friend eat it or not? Later they'll come after me. Yaar. I mean, this should be explanatory.
So the story behind Jain chicken is that a lot of Jains eat, want to eat chicken outside their houses because ghar pe wo kha nahi sakte. So the deal is that they still don't like to eat it with garlic and onion because when they come back, when they come back home, you can smell the garlic and onion on your...
So, paap ka level hote hai, basically.
No, when they come back home, their parents or whoever is in their family can smell the garlic and onion, but they cannot smell the chicken. And these are problems that we don't have as North
They cannot smell the chicken from this end.
Yeah,
if they wait a little while, ek aur jagah se perhaps khushbu hai.
Instead of using malai or cream or butter, the person, the YouTuber, uses coconut milk.
But they're eating meat. Yet they are not eating the other smaller issues that they have.
Yeah. Because of all the lactose intolerant people around.
This hypocrisy only works in India. It's perfect.
Yeah.
Because I think it just makes sense.
And it's called butter chicken, for God's sake. Makhan to dalo usme. Butter to dalo usme.
Talk about biryani, boss. Next is butter chicken. They throw the butter chicken at you sometimes. Yeah. And in our part of the world, there's so much... Oh, I don't, what they call butter chicken is... I can't tell you, yaar. It's sirf oil hai. सिर्फ तेल है उसमें
चीनी भी तो होती है बॉम्बे के बटर चिकन में
या दिस ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ आई मीन वी हैव टू थ्री प्लेसेस व्हिच आर स्टैंडर्ड दैट वे डेफिनेटली आई थिंक बटर चिकन वी शुड जस्ट ईट इन नॉर्थ इंडिया आई डोंट थिंक वी कैन मेक इट प्रॉपर्ली हियर जस्ट वी हैव गेलॉर्स व्हिच इज रियली गुड मे बी कपल शेरे पंजाब दे हैव सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्रेडिशन बट अदर देन दैट इफ यू गो टू द चिलिया रेस्टोरेंट्स द स्मॉलर रेस्टोरेंट्स एंड ऑल इट्स जस्ट It's a Bombay butter chicken, which we are used to, but it is not butter chicken. That is the problem.
I think Bombay butter chicken also has, which is a very unique thing about Bombay. I think they add tomato sauce in that. Instead, like in North, they don't add tomato sauce. In North, they add tomato.
But rang mein farak hai na? Because I think up North is more orangey, the color.
Yes,
very strong.
Yes.
Just like the government. Or apna side mein, it's like a dark color, like a brown.
The brown, so that's a big... The Bombay influence and also like different kind of masalas that they use, right? So, for example, Delhi people can't really make a good, let's say, vada pav, right? Because of...
Don't compare vada pav to butter chicken, for God's sake.
There's no talent required to make vada pav.
He's just now... So, we have become so insecure, all us minorities. Just for safety's sake, he's saying this. How can you compare vada pav to butter chicken? Vada pav is because there's nothing available. Pav, vada, bang, slap, maro.
Muslim. Nahari to I mean you can get good nahari.
I mean if I
well.
Take do gareeb se poochho, here's butter chicken, here's vada pav. The guy who takes vada pav, you make him the prime minister. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah, with like vada pav and chai as well, by the way. Aise kaise?
Theek hai. Kehne mein kya harz hai? We can change
it.
Let's go into a break.
Advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.
You were discussing the butter chicken being vegan. But shouldn't there be a law that if the food is not what it's actually, it should not be given that title? I mean, just basically a biryani, butter chicken, the game changers. Because those are the ones you are safe with. Na? Wherever we travel, if we see biryani, we don't know what the other food is. We think it's a biryani, we are safe, let's eat it. And if that biryani turns out to be something vegan, this, that, wo, usme peas hai, you know, aloo hai, whatever, it just changes completely.
Yeah, true. Absolutely.
I think I was in Bangladesh once and then they on the menu there was Shahi Murgh Makhni. And I was like, what is this Shahi Murgh Makhni? And from the restaurant chef, he comes and he knew I'm from India. So he's like, sir, this is butter chicken. I'm like, to usko butter chicken bolo, Shahi kya likh diya? Shahi Murgh Makhni kya hai?
Shahi kya hota hai?
Shahi basically anything in North part, anything that you have dry fruits and nuts,
title.
That becomes Shahi.
Oh.
Kyunki royals apparently used to eat a lot of nuts and dry fruits.
Shah se?
Nahin, Shahi like royal.
I mean, just to butt in with a boring economic fact again.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's shy because dry fruits are historically expensive. I mean, they're still quite expensive. So anybody who can afford to put dry fruits in their gravy is, yeah. I mean, shahi only.
Shahi, like, aap to royal, aap to bade, yeah. bade log hain aap.
Haan, bade log, bade log.
But this is a good point, yaar. These are India's, what you call it, export dishes as well.
Yeah.
Chicken tikka masala, England claims to be their best dish now and that they make it better. I mean, Indians must have made it, but that it's better than anything else. So you think when we go abroad, that some of our standard dishes are matched? We can get a good biryani. We can get a, you have mentioned in Bangladesh, you get a decent butter chicken. Forget the name.
So the places that I have traveled so far, I always think that ek tone down rakhte hain kyunki they have to cater to their own Indian
spice
audience.
Come, for example.
Spices come rahega. Like for example, in Delhi, there's a Andhra restaurant. And the reason I like them, it's called Tenali. The reason I like them because they're unapologetic about it. Spicy hai to hai. Pasand hai to khao, nahi to jao. And that's what I think a lot of restaurants abroad doesn't do. They like spicy to nahi bilkul to ek tone down kar dena hai kyunki local audience hai. Kyunki Indians to
aa. But even Indians, even Indians ka stomachs, I think abroad, like my sister's been there 25 years. She can't eat our chutneys and pani when she comes here and all. They become like that. They become weak. Foreigners are weak here. I hope this is not racist to say.
Yeah.
No, it is not, I think. So yeah, that's why I think that they tone it down. They sort of dump it down a little bit. Ki haan, sab log taki aaram se kha paaye.
Yeah.
I went to Spain, I think, a few years back. And wahan pe we were, my parents and I, we were thinking ki we'll try all the fancy dishes, paella, tapas. And we did that for 2-3 days. Then one day, like, I think halfway into our trip, we got drunk on beers, lots of beers.
And Indian food ka wo...
Fair aage ki yaar butter chicken khana hai. And then we went to then we actually were walking on the streets and we realized there's so many Indians everywhere because every 8th person was an Indian and we were asking them ki boss Indian khana acha kaha milega and all of them actually directed us to a good place and the food was actually pretty good. This was in Barcelona.
So what did you eat?
Mughlai style, butter chicken, tandoori chicken, dal makhani, or
and the spices were up to the mark and all that.
Yeah. And the server there was talking in Punjabi. So that's always a good
I would have walked out there. Yeah. I paid money to come to Barcelona. The guy's talking to me in Punjabi. Yeah. I mean, ridiculous.
The first time I went to Europe, I got out of the airport, and the first thing I heard was a maa bhen ki gali from in a Punjabi in Punjabi style. I was like, yeah, this is what I come
to. Amritsar to nahi le aaya.
And I love, when I go to England, I love the Gujarati and Punjabi with the drawls because they are born and bred there. So the accent, the way they deliver the lines are with, you know, slower. So it's like, ki haal hai. I'm like, oh, wow. It just sounds like fun, yaar. But, you know, in London, for example, your bhelpuri costs like £7, which is somewhat, some like 7,000 rupees or whatever, 700 rupees for one bhel, which is $5 or $10 in our cities. Do you think you can make a lot of money with Indian food? Which is really like cheap to produce here and just go abroad and milk it now with the GDP collapsing.
I think because what I have noticed in the recent past is that Indian food is really rising. So abroad as well as of course in India, young people are now like nahi Indian khana khana hai. So of course fusion bhi ho raha hai aur confusion bhi ho raha hai us chakkar mein. Lekin bahar mein same cheez street food ko bilkul Michelin star style mein you serve it and you plate and it becomes that really fancy. And then you'll be like, oh, and then you can charge whatever amount that you are willing to or planning to.
But Sadhav, there's massive competition for Indian restaurants even outside. And, you know, in fact, we...
Amongst Indian restaurants.
Yeah. And it's so popular. We tweeted the trailer for our podcast. And British people started retweeting us saying that this is something I'm interested in. They read the word naan and
to
curry.
Promote
and, curry. Yeah, they wanted to, you know, listen to it. But sadly, our podcast is a mix of Hindi and English. So
they but naan curry kyu? Why have you taken naan and curry with generally? I don't know, but I feel like curry and naan don't go together for me.
Yeah, this is a word play. Achit, please.
So the idea was that Indian food is known abroad for curry. And we wanted to specify that we are just not just curry, so non-curry.
So non-curry bhi ek shabd hota, I think. Non-curry, it just sounds like some word you have made up.
So non with an accent which is like, non-curry.
South Hall se aage aapne, that's a theek hai. So non-curry bole hai.
Non-curry.
Mother chill. They're 5 stick longer than Delhi, I'll tell you that. Teri maa ki mein. Three mark, just 5 seconds more. Yeah, very, very interesting. So, no, let's get back to now what this Naan Curry is all about. Are you all going to be reviewing food or just discussing food? What's the soul of the show?
We're talking about food. So I look into the history and the cultural background of food, and that's what I enjoy. Alchit, on the other hand, is going to bring on the economics and the behavioral science of that part. So both of us are talking about what we eat and why we eat.
Behavioral science, kya hota hai isme?
Ye Alchit batayenge, bhari word.
So, kitna time lagega isme? Tell us.
So I just to add to what Sadhav said, actually, there is also a lot of elitism around intellectual conversations about food in India. They're usually in English, they're usually about some fancy pasta or some fancy Parmesan cheese. But we want to make this site more local. We want to, you know, make Indian food great again, as they would say. We want to talk about...
You sound like Obama.
Yeah.
Make India food great again.
So you want to talk about ancient foods that have, you know, some of them are not there in our diets, some of them are there in our diets. We want to revive them. We want to talk about millet, for example. We want to talk about jaggery. We want to talk about everything that we've eaten over the past 400-500 years in India. Just get Indian people to be proud of our culinary heritage again.
But there are some groups who are saying that they want to remove Mughlai food and all, like Mughal history. And I mean, there's a wave of movement that wants
Most Mughlai food is actually not Mughlai food, it's Punjabi food. They just...
Kaise batao?
Yeah.
Nobody wants to listen. They just... Mughal ne laya. Take it out.
So that's the funny thing. In fact, that hamari history thodi si kamzor, thodi kya bahut kamzor hai. We think bas India mein Mughal aaye aur Mughalon ne barbaad kar diya apparently. And so bas Mughal ko bahar karo. In fact, you would not believe, a few days back, popुलर चैनल टीवी चैनल, उनका इंस्टाग्राम हैंडल है, उसमें दे पुट अप कुतुब मीनार, ठीक है, एंड कि कुतुब मीनार वॉज बिल्ट बाई मुगल्स. And I said, so I corrected this person as well. And I said, listen, Qutub Minar was not built by Mughals. There's a small monument inside Qutub Minar premise, which is built by Mughals, but not Qutub Minar. He said, no, but Google mein to likha tha Qutub Minar.
Qutubuddin Aibak. Exactly. The name.
Like the first one, right? And they're like, no, lekin Google ne to bola ki Qutub Minar was built by Mughals. I'm like, that is, I mean, Google says a lot of things, but you need to read properly. So that's the problem. I think har cheez Mughal hai. In fact, if you go to Pliny Dili, which is popular for the Mughal food, so much of dish that we eat are not Mughal anymore. They're just bastardized versions. So Mughals, for example, never used to eat so much of heavy food.
But sir, why do we have to even apologize for all this? I don't understand that. Food is food, yaar. At least let something in life. It's like sport, you know. End of the day, if I like Ronaldo, I'll follow Ronaldo. What the hell difference does it make? Food is food. If food comes from Poland and I like it, I can't say that chaap hai mere peet pe ki they were ruling us or something, so I can't eat. I mean, it doesn't make any sense, yaar.
I think we have small egos, so we identify ourselves with all these things. We identify ourselves with being Ronaldo fans. We identify ourselves with being butter chicken eaters of certain kinds. So it hurts us personally when somebody talks about another kind of food or another kind of player.
Correct.
It's sad.
So I think the interesting would be, like, for example, when Mughals came in, of course, theek hai, they brought their food, but that doesn't mean that they changed the food.
Babar ji ne kya laya? And I say ji because he's a personal friend. He brought fruit more than anything else.
Exactly.
So isme kya hai? I mean, like, what is the crime? We can't just think everything is a crime.
Huh. And they didn't bring new dishes altogether. Like, of course, they brought a lot of different kinds of dishes, and mostly Akbar, because Akbar didn't really fight a lot of different wars. He had the empire ready and he was just managing them. So a lot of dishes were sort of local dishes were getting developed. So aisa nahi tha ki Indians, like, bolte rahe, acha India khana Mughal hi hai, theek hai, Mughal inspired a lot of dishes, lekin baki Hindustani khana hi to hai, matlab usi ko halka halka tweak kar diya gaya.
So ye biryani jo hai and butter chicken jo hai, these two, would you say they are more Punjabi North Indian dishes, or biryani has its origin in Iran or Arabia?
So that's what we have an episode on. Actually, we have episodes on both butter chicken as well as biryani. We're talking about both the dishes in detail. So there are two sort of history of biryani. One which talks about that we Indians have had similar kind of dishes. And the document or account is from 2 AD, which is in Tamil Nadu, which is the dish is called Onsoru.
What are you saying?
So, yeah. So that was one. Biryani, however, what we know, came during Shah Jahan's time, not even Akbar's time, Shah Jahan's time. And for example, the biryani we eat versus the biryani which the Iranians or the Persians have are very different, because their biryani is a flat bread, like a paratha, uske upar gosht. Or biryan is a word for onions, like fried onion, right? So fried onion se, to jitni bhi recipes hain, usme फ्राइड अनियन का जिक्र है, तो अकबरनामा में जिक्र है फ्राइड अनियन का, लेकिन इट्स नॉट कॉल्ड बिरयानी. शाहजहां के टाइम पे इसको बिरयानी का नाम दिया गया कि इसको बिरयानी बोलते हैं, बिकॉज वन पॉट मील एंड दे वॉन्टेड टू डेवलप अप वन पॉट मील फॉर द आर्मी, जो उनके सिपा साला थे उनके लिए, कि पिकनिक मनाए थोड़े नहीं जा रहे हो, जंग पे जा रहे हो, तो वन पॉट मील लेके जाओ तुम. एंड दैट्स हाउ द बिरयानी केम इन, राइट?
एंड आफ्टर फिनिशिंग ईटिंग दे कैन यूज द पॉट फॉर अदर थिंग्स. सो दिस इज गुड थिंकिंग हियर, गुड थिंकिंग.
एग्जैक्टली,
इफ इट वाज अ बैड बिरयानी.
Only if it. So that's what, and then now what we have is a very different version of the biryani, and same goes with butter chicken as well. Butter chicken actually is a very Punjab, and it is, so people say, oh, butter chicken is also Mughalai, right? Kyun? Kyunki chicken hai, kyunki meat hai, but butter chicken is very, very Punjabi. Tandoori chicken is very Punjabi.
And the origin story of butter chicken is very similar to my Spain drinking story. It's about two Punjabis met at a theka. They were drinking and they were like, chalo, बटर चिकन बनाते हैं, चलो रेस्टोरेंट खोलते हैं, पंजाबी रेस्टोरेंट. एंड इवेंचुअली दे इन्वेंटेड बटर चिकन इन दैट रेस्टोरेंट, व्हिच वाज मोती महल इन
दिल्ली. बटर एंड एक्चुअल यूसेज ऑफ मक्खन एंड घी एंड ऑल दैट इज वेरी नॉर्थ, इजंट इट?
या,
यू डंप इट इन मोस्ट ऑफ द फूड.
Yeah, so I think, so that's what the written document talks about, right? Like when the capital was moving to Delhi from Agra during Shah Jahan's reign, the Hakim was saying ki no, Delhi ka pani bahut kharab hai. So they were like, ab kya kiya jaye? To Delhi ko isliye spicy khana khilaya jaye taki जो इम्प्योरिटीज ऑफ वाटर है वो कट जाए. लेकिन दिल्ली हमेशा से हॉट रहा है, तो अगर इतनी गर्मी है तो इतना स्पाइसी खाएंगे तो मर जाएंगे. तो फिर क्या किया जाए? तो हकीमों ने बोला कि चलो इसमें थोड़ा सा ग्रीस जाएगा, थोड़ा फैट जाएगा. एंड दैट्स हाउ द एंटायर नॉर्थ इंडिया स्टिल ऑब्सेस्ड विद ग्रीसी.
बट ग्रीस से क्या होता है एग्जैक्टली? ग्रीस से क्या क्या फायदा है?
ग्रीस मतलब फैट बेसिकली. उससे स्पाइसेस जो होता है थोड़ा सा टोन डाउन, मेलो डाउन होता है.
ओ, इज दैट सो?
या, इन फैक्ट इन माय हाउस अगर कुछ ज्यादा मसालेदार कुछ बन गया तो उसमें दूध डाल दो या क्रीम डाल दो या मलाई डाल दो, इट विल टोन डाउन.
अच्छा, दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई यू पुट मलाई एंड ऑल इन इट?
या,
टू ब्रिंग इट डाउन द स्पाइस.
या, सो इन मोस्ट ऑफ द नॉर्थ इंडियन फूड यू विल सी मलाई का इस्तेमाल, लाइक व्हिच इज नॉट इन साउथ फूड. द रीजन आई लाइक, आई थिंक साउथ फूड आई लाइक मोर, बिकॉज जो बोलते हैं इज्जत देना खाने को वो देते हैं, क्योंकि अगर चिकन मटन वेज जो भी है तो दे इंश्योर कि हाँ उसमें ज्यादा मसाला डाल के ओवर पावर ना करें. वर्सेस नॉर्थ में क्या होता है, हैवी मसाला, हैवी फैट होता है उसके अंदर.
नहीं तो आपका कहने का मतलब है कि अगर क्लाइंट या कस्टमर फैट है, मोटा है, इज गॉट लॉट ऑफ वेट, हिज टेंडेंसी इज नॉट टू गेट द स्पाइस बिकॉज ऑफ द फैट.
अपना खुद का फैट कैसे खा लिया,
तो वेटर बोलते हैं मोटा आ गया, उसके और स्पाइस कर ले.
We should test that.
I think so. There may be some correlation with body types. Who knows? Okay, guys, very interesting. But before we wrap up, I just want to ask you all personally, what do you all like? What is your favorite color? I know this is a very difficult thing to answer. It's like asking somebody who's the most beautiful girl in the world. Which I wish we could do a podcast on that and just show visuals.
And video cast.
Video cast.
And ensure everybody's hands are up in that podcast.
अभी क्या करेगा हम लोग ना? 6-7 महीने में कुछ खेल वेल कुछ नहीं है यार. Don't be so cruel. Think from my point of view, बेटा. I'm 49 and married 20 years. मेरा कुछ future नहीं है.
I remember seeing that Instagram post of yours, which where somebody's asking, I am single in lockdown, may what should I masturbate or not?
No, yeah, lot of people are. I mean, why hesitate? The world becomes a better place if you remove the shakti, so to speak. Favorite foods, guys. Really. Achit, come Achit. On.
Mine is butter chicken and the one from Moti Mahal. In fact, I studied...
You claim to be the original?
Yes. I went to college in Bombay, to NM.
Where?
College. NM.
NM?
Yeah. And
yeah, the street vendors they used to have in the canteen was quite famous, but yeah, all veg.
Huh. All veg, yeah. So I actually missed butter chicken so much that I wrote a poem about it.
Beautiful. Yeah. People write about suffering, love, lament, ye wo, revolution, and you write about missing butter chicken.
Yeah.
And we call it a garib desh.
Yeah.
Just tell me, if the citizens are thinking like that, why are you saying poor country? It's not a poor country.
This was also suffering, right? Suffering and pain and misery.
I totally accept it. I think food is underrated. What food is therapeutic, you know.
Yeah.
Food se aapko jo solution milte hai in the mind, you'll never get, I think, from a therapist also.
Yeah.
You just feel better immediately. Huh. Sorry,
it's therapeutic. It makes you sleep. It's the solution to everything.
Yeah, and if you eat enough garlic and onions, you can get rid of the woman.
Yeah.
The guy Sadaf immediately came in. Huh? He came in. Obviously, ho gaya ek do baar ho gaya. Maybe not by choice. Janbujh ke second time. First time it was by mistake.
Khelo dimag.
Chalo, niklo, niklo.
People don't understand. They fall in love all the time. And I love this girl. I love this guy. Whatever. Nothing is more difficult than getting rid of people. Getting them actually is not the toughest if you work hard. But getting rid. Because, I mean, there's no way to do that properly. Sorry. So you were saying butter chicken. You missed it and you wrote. Did you have the poem?
I do.
Let's hear it. Sunanu, yeah, please.
Okay. Make do without her, they said. I paid no heed. Because she's the only one. Leaves me more intoxicated than weed. I'd travel 1,000 miles for her. I'll admit that without any qualms. Just to get a whiff of her in full glory and caress her legs with my palms. I want her in my bedroom, my kitchen, and my car. Heck, I want her with a shivers in my neighborhood bar. When my lips touch her breast, it gives me the chills. She's not good for my heart, they say. Getting too attached to her kills. A sight of her in orange leaves me hungry and smitten. She's spicy yet tender. Oh, my butter chicken.
Wow, yaar. But don't come near my daughter. You sound like a pervert. You sound disgusting. Disgusting.
This
is only sexually aroused. What do you say? Be neutral and tell me. Is there no sexual imagery or hai ya nahi?
See, I think in Bombay, he was not just missing butter chicken, but a lot of other things as well.
Exactly.
Sare jazbaat jo hai idhar udhar chale gaye.
100%. Wo confused aadmi hai, bhai. Because he was not getting any luck with the NM crowd for some reason. So exactly. Between the butter chicken and let's say the butter other things, he was stuck for a little while. Did it improve? Your scorecard improved after some time?
Butter chicken scorecard, no.
Achha, other one we're talking about other one.
So in the next time he presents the poem, wo leg or breast reference nahi hai.
Haan, usme nahi hai. Normal.
Exactly. Yeah. But lovely. So nice to meet someone who's written a poem on food. It was deep down. I didn't think people focus on that. The world will be a better place.
Absolutely.
Instead of focusing on all the contempt and hate that some TV channels for some reason have decided to make into a national pastime. But that is a story for another day. Maybe he's not eating the right food, yaar, Sadaf.
I think he's
that
not.
That particular gentleman.
Yeah.
He's not sleeping enough also.
Not sleeping enough?
Yeah. Lou Coutinho mentioned on your show that sleeping is like 30-40% of getting better. Maybe he should hire Luke.
Study the world's greatest villains, you know, the Hitlers and all of whatever information we have. And see, in look at behavior patterns, like you're a behavioral scientist. Is there such a thing? That certain people, they don't eat the right foods and, you know, so they are deprived. They deprive themselves spiritually almost. And then there's a lot of hatred and anger and toxic stuff that comes out.
Happens, of course. The food we eat influences our behavior all the time.
So can you come up with a poem right now? Anything that rhymes with Roswami. It's a tough one.
It takes time to think about it.
Yeah.
I think, you know, that what yoga says, like cuff with... So I think एक थोड़ा सा ऊपर नीचे है
सर आप कौन सा एंगल से योगा करते हैं आजकल
नहीं यू
बड़ी हेल्दी टॉकिंग अबाउट इट लाइक मैं जो दीजिए योगी है उस या देयर इज ओनली वन योगी
अपसाइड डाउन
There's only one yogi. Thank God.
लगता है आप गलत योगा कर रहे हैं सदर इसको योगा नहीं कहते
ऊपर दिखा दो
आयु
इसमें कोई शर्म नहीं है दिखा
नहीं
लंगोट पहना है या नहीं
हाँ पहना ना full pant.
We are trying to promote the show, beta. Some lobby will like it. You just do a headstand and leave it to advertising.
ab tum jano and like Muslim guy doing yoga. Aadha Muslim wale aa jayenge fatwa nikalenge. How dare you do yoga? And then other people will call me and say, okay, come on my channel and then talk about yoga. That you promote yoga.
Don't worry. You're always welcome in Parsi households. As long as you can cook biryani. Don't worry.
Yes. Yes.
We are not interested in yoga. There's no Parsi doing any yoga. Don't worry about that. Okay, guys, before we go into AMAs, last bit about the show. Are you going to interview people? Podcast pe? Restaurant wale, food critic, food lovers.
Yes. And, you know, Abhi, we want to first start with around 20-30 dishes which are very important to India. Talk about them, talk about the history, talk about the incentives that influence eating them, and then eventually interview people. One of the ideas, in fact, is to interview somebody who manages the diets of sports persons, because my two interests are cricket and food. So I want to know how cricketers eat, what they eat. I know there's Virat Kohli's vegan, but I'm sure not every cricketer is vegan.
West Delhi boy.
Yeah.
What a waste.
Yeah.
And he wasn't. He was a hardcore, normal Punjabi kid, you know, drinking, eating, everything. And then suddenly turned.
Yeah.
This is what marriage does to you.
He actually said it's his wife.
लड़की के चक्कर बाबू भाई, लड़की के चक्कर.
मैं कुछ नहीं बोलने वाला इसके बारे में, because I am also married. You should not get into all this. Are you, you all are not married, right?
No.
No.
No. No.
Not yet. Okay. No. Looking not for yet. Someone?
Not yet.
Not no.
But it'll be a big issue if the food is not matching, huh? Food taste.
I know that. Then to बिल्कुल जंग हो जाएगी.
Oh, what was the dialogue? My girlfriend's a vegetarian, so that pretty much makes me a vegetarian. Yeah, you'll have to, something like that, but I'm more worried that he will psych out the girl, being a both of you actually, because you are a critic, so without knowing it, instead of tarif, you'll start slowly criticizing, and before you know it, you're in a normal marriage. Is that what you want, beta? Be careful.
But remember, you said like getting is not a problem. Getting rid of them is a problem. So ye ek hamara ye tarika ho sakta hai how to get rid of them.
Ye scheme hai.
Just by cooking better than her, she's psyched out and goes back to mummy. Is it? मुझे नहीं चाहिए.
ये नहीं चाहिए. I want. मेरे मेरे को चार allowed है. अपना चलेगा. अच्छी तरह अपना देख लो.
चार. तू एक रख पहला बेटा. फिर चार के बारे में पूछो. बहुत है. Many people trying to return the first one. What are you talking about?
हाँ लेकिन ये product अच्छा नहीं है. इसको Amazon पे वापस करो.
So far, its government is not approved of returning. The guarantee is expiring as we speak. Cool. Listen, guys. So great. The show is great. I hope we'll also talk about foods which are beyond the top 10. Na, apna jo popular biryanis or butter chickens or dosas and this and that. We have to. There's so much khana. Like someone told me, there are more biryanis in South India than there are in North India, which nobody knows. Like in Tamil Nadu, it has more biryani culture than any other state, which I didn't think was possible.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely. In fact, one of my favorite biryanis is biryani from Kerala. And since Kerala was open for trade for longer than
before
most
else,
parts of India, so it has more spice than anywhere else.
South has very different kinds of flavor as well. So if you talk about South starting from Hyderabad, every state will have different kind of flavor as compared to the North part, which doesn't really have so many different kinds of flavors.
And East bhi hai na, Oriya cooking, I don't have much color. I don't think I've ever had. Bengali cooking also, we have a little bit, but it's the same five dishes which they show us in the big cities. Correct. And there's much more to that. And Bangladeshi khana is a little different from West Bengal, East Bengal khana. There's a difference, all that.
Correct. Yeah.
So maybe you'd get a sponsor to make you travel. Then you can enjoy all the different parts.
That would be amazing. That would be the best.
Main phone karta hu. Just who you want, Pepsi or Coke?
Aap lagaiye phone.
अभी हम कोक से काम चलाएंगे.
अरे वाईफाई का इशू है भाई, वाईफाई का इशू.
अरे अरे अरे
अभी मेरा पॉन भी चालू नहीं होता है. डैम इट
शिट
व्हाट टू डू रेस्ट ऑफ द डे.
वो वीपीएन हब डाउनलोड करना पड़ेगा. हाँ वीपीएन डाउनलोड करना पड़ेगा, अदरवाइज सरकार ने बैन कर दिया है.
नहीं नहीं, अपेरेंटली इट वर्क्स वेरी गुड इन पार्लियामेंट. यू नो दैट स्टोरी ना.
हाँ, इट वर्क्स वेरी वेल. दे लाइक ये क्या पका दे, चलो देख लेते.
आई जस्ट वांट टू बिकम अ मिनिस्टर फॉर दैट. यहाँ पे वाईफाई है भाई. ओके,
यहाँ पे सब कुछ अलाउड है.
They make the rules. All right, we'll go to AMAs. Ask me anything on this show called Cyrus Says. This is the worst podcast you'll ever be on. After that, you'll never have to suffer like this again. You have reached now the worst point. It's only upwards from here, which is what I think we should say to the nation.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Want to wish you all a happy Diwali. Hope you had a great festive season. It's been a great week in terms of the kinds of guests we've had and the kind of conversations we've had on the network this week. Do definitely check some of these things out. On This Rounds On Me with Gauri Devideyal, she had a great conversation with Garima Arora, who's one of the best-known chefs in the world. It was just absolutely riveting. Do check that out. On States of Anarchy, Hamsini Hariran spoke about chronicling India's different wars. Again, really interesting episode. Check that out. Ashton had a very interesting episode on his show, The Habit Coach. It was called I Don't Feel Like Doing Anything. It's about how to overcome malaise just generally, and I thought really, really interesting stuff. Kumi Vayana was the guest on Cyrus Says on Monday's episode last week, and she's an educator, and my God, it was such a fascinating conversation talking about the way education functions in India and some of the changes she'd like to see. Just really, really interesting stuff. Do give that a listen. On Uncle Please Sit, Anupam Manur was there with Joel and Tushar talking about the Indian economy, part one of a two-part series. Second part will be out this week. You should definitely check that out. Lastly, I want to talk to you all about the Filter Coffee podcast. Karthik Nagarajan, who hosts that show, is on a little bit of a break. He's back with a banger of an episode. It is with Himura Maya, who used to run Landmark Stores, and they talk about the culture of bookstores and quizzing and all kinds of stuff. Really interesting conversation. Do check that out. And with that, let me get you back to your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Silvery, welcome back.
Hey guys, what's up? All right, getting to the first AMA. First one comes in from Vineet Ayer. He says, hey, Cyrus and guest, or guests this time. Guys, I miss making prank calls and receiving wrong numbers. I remember prank calls were a great way of killing time when hanging with friends in our younger days. Not only that, I remember having a lot of fun when I got a wrong call as well. Whoever they would ask for on the wrong call, I would always go, "Arey, haan hai na, wo bas aa raha hai," and try and continue conversations to hilarious effect. I really miss that. Especially in times like these, it would have been great to be able to make prank calls to kill time. What about you guys? Were you or your friends ever big on this? And what would you think of bringing this culture back somehow?
अरे मैं अभी भी करता हूँ. Firstly, at the age of 49, I think if you don't do prank calls growing up, you're a chooth. Now, I can't think of another word.
Agreed.
How can you not? To pass time, right? No?
Correct. True calling has ruined it for us.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. But you can borrow phones.
Yeah.
Especially on studios and all, where there are a lot of people, or wherever you're working, offices, and there are a lot of people, just borrow phones. The musti is double then. If that motherfucker gets into trouble, you're not even involved. But taking a phone and a person doesn't know who's talking, you know, how can you be? I just love that. I just feel happy that I fucked his day up.
Did you guys ever make a prank call and then realize, oh shit, the other person has caller ID? did that happen?
No, we, caller ID ka, I think Kunal, my friend, he asked a girl out. I hope, Kunal, you don't mind us telling this story of your shame. Because as usual, aapka failure rate, I mean, you're the opposite of Virat Kohli. The average is really low. And there was a girl, we were doing a play with her many years ago. And he tried to call her and he said, yeah, she's coming for drinks and yevo. Sab chaloge, Friday night, we're all waiting there. 8:30, 9:30, nobody turns up. So then I said, call her. So he called and on his mobile phone, she called back. And she said, I'm in the Taj. I'm calling from home. My mother is sick. And the home number was a completely separate thing. But this was, we checked it. It was Taj Mahal ka. You know, those same numbers like 2202202. So it sounded strange. So she was in Taj enjoying herself with somebody else. And bichara Kunal, another failure.
This is why you should call yourself Gourmand and not the foodie.
Gourmand.
That's the word.
Man, I remember once I called.
Sounds even bad in a gali.
I remember once I dialed a prank call on 100, on 100, the cops. So stupid. I don't know, as a kid, right? As a, like a dumb 11-year-old kid, I dialed the cops and immediately got the call back. Like, hello, is number the call? I'm like, no, nothing happened. Are what? I just got the call.
I think now you want to irritate the cops. You call up and say, hey, suicide or murder? Just keep that. Every 5 minutes, bench up. Suicide or murder? Just keep, every 5 minutes, just keep calling. Ask the same thing.
I never knew 100 number actually works this well. Mujhe laga
number first time they picked it up.
First time they picked up and you got.
Cut to Silvery being beaten by 5 chores in the house. Robbery happening. Phone laga
the. The boy who cried wolf. All right. Next one comes in from Sahil Lalwani. He says, "Hi, Cyrus and guests. I have a little bit of a dilemma. My wife has been going crazy buying kitchen utensils/gadgets during this time. We bought an OTG oven, an air fryer, an extra microwave, a mini fridge, countless new sharp knives, each of which have an apparently different purpose. One knife is for cutting meat, supposedly. Another one is for veggies. And I don't know what the rest are for other than opening food packets. We bought an induction plate as well. Now that we've bought all this, I feel like my wife feels pressure to justify the purchases and is making extra dishes that I never thought we'd be seeing at home. Not only that, she has been forcing me to cook as well. I mean, she bought the stuff, why should I do the work? How do I get out of it the next time she tells me to make something? And please, how do I stop her from buying these endless kitchen items?"
Silvery, such long letters we can keep for a whole podcast, no?
Yeah,
cool. The longest letter ever, let the boys answer because they are the food experts here.
I would say whatever stuff you have got, please send it to me. I can give you my address. I have big enough house. Dil aur ghar hamara bahut bada hai. Sab adjust kar lenge.
Aur khana bhi pakayega aap.
Khana bhi apne liye pakaunga. Matlab bhejunga nahi, apne liye pakaunga. Yahan chal jayega, apna adjust ho jayega. Bhejo.
But
I love taking gifts.
They can become home chefs and, you know, sell their stuff.
नहीं, but उनको नहीं चाहिए ना खाना बनाने का नहीं है उनको.
So he's feeling कि she's pressurized him into cooking.
हाँ,
which is the wife's dominating behavior is unbelievable. She has bought all this stuff on his credit card and now she wants him only to cook. So I think that she is ready for politics. This woman is fantastic. Because she will oppress the oppressed even more, which is the right way to rule.
ये क्या husband क्या minority में है क्या?
I saw a shirt once in airport in New York. I'm black, Jewish, gay and proud. That's really funny. We should all just put in all the labels and say, you know, this is the situation. Bol, Silvery, bol.
Going on to the next one then. Last one. Comes in from Monish Nair. This is a very short one. Don't worry. He says, hey, Cyrus, Silvery and guest. Hope you all are doing well. Do you guys think in a relationship between a man and a woman, marriage or otherwise, it's easier for a woman to inspire / encourage a man to change his habits as opposed to the other way around? I would like to know what you guys think.
I come back to governments. The only way to do this is fear. If you're scared of your wife or scared of your parents, you'll end up doing it. If you're not scared, nothing will happen. So try and marry someone you're not scared of so you have a peaceful life. That's all I can say. Now let's talk to bachelors. So kya kehna hai pata nahi, but let them talk. Huh?
Ye abhi bola na, isse pehle wale question mein tha na, that the woman is trying to influence the man.
Why do people do that, yaar? Why do you have to get into a relationship, even with a friend, why do you have to get into a relationship and try and change person?
I
think that's fascism. That's where it begins. Why do you have to change someone? That's your person. Me. We get along, Fuck it if you're veg or non-veg. Fuck it if you're this tribe or that tribe. Who gives a fuck? I'm telling you, human beings can only unite on philosophy. All this is shit. Race, religion, nationality, all crap. In the end of the day, people are like-minded or not like-minded. I've given this example, me and this Pakistani guy in watching the Champions Trophy 2017, how we bonded sitting there in the stadium. Because we just started making fun of our own countries. Around us, they're going, Pakistan Zindabad, Hindustan Zindabad. And we just started making fun of the fucking citizens of our own countries. And that's why we bonded.
Yeah.
And I think that's how you actually end up, being a group of people. Because you have the same sort of way of thinking.
I think my issue only starts when a girl would put coconut milk in butter chicken. Uske alawa, I'm okay with anything.
No, ye to serious crime hai, sir. I'm not talking about murder or coconut in food and all that.
We're just talking about lower things. Different philosophy, different ideas. Huh. I think we need to laugh on ourselves to begin with.
Yeah,
jab tak khud pe nahi hasenge, to aise nahi to phir zyada proud ho jata hai ki wo mera zyada acha hai. Mera butter chicken tumhara butter chicken.
Agar aap kisi ko correct karna hai na, to why are you even getting involved? Because that already you are negative.
Yeah.
No, like if you think Archit is like a chooth and you told me offline all this, then why are you his friend?
Correct. Like Bardash nahi kar rahe. Bardash gaali khila do usko ya khud kha lo nikal lo.
Sir, this is a boy who cried because butter chicken he did not taste for 6 months somewhere in bloody Mumbai. Which I don't understand why. You'll get some type of butter chicken.
Yeah, it wasn't the OG.
Just go to a house which had Kapoor written on it or something, knock on the door and beg them for khana, yaar.
Goela. Salanch wahan pe nahi the us time.
Tab I used to live in Kulaba, wahan tak deliver nahi karta tha.
Abhi Kulaba mein start kiya hai Salanch ne.
Kulaba mein you would have got so many options, yaar. Butter chicken. Sherry Punjab is 5 minutes away. Gaylords is 5 minutes away. Very good. Call me, yaar, next time.
Ye budget pe tha na.
Oh, budget wali baat, I can't help you with that. Because I make Kunal pay, so I don't know about money.
Although it was very impressive that Archit knew the poem by heart. He didn't have to take out a
piece of paper. Were you reading or you knew?
I was reading.
You're reading? Oh, okay. Yeah. You had it ready then?
Yeah.
झूठ झूठ बोल देते कि हाँ मतलब याद था.
I know, yaar, you spoiled the whole thing. You were a genius. You know, yaar, what is a big deal? Damn it. We learn something new every day. All right. Are we done, sir?
Yep, you're done.
You're done? Okay. What's the name of the podcast? Naan Curry. You say it together, it's Naan Curry.
Sounds like.
Yeah, or Naan Curry.
Naan Curry.
Yeah.
Because your influence will be Europe and everywhere else.
Yeah. So, we hope they'll be able to understand our Hindi.
Yeah.
What is there? Language is never a bar, yaar. People have passion. Passion will bring you together. Don't worry. How do you think I landed in Pila House? Which is a famous area of Mumbai which Archit will tell Sadaf offline about.
Please tell me Pila House.
It is the oldest profession in the world.
Achha.
And the rates are also very old. And the clients who go and the providers are also very old.
Hence the attire so that you can switch very quickly.
Anji. Yeah. And disputable gender. Bhi hai. So, aap panche pek peene ke paas jao, please. Yeah. Otherwise, it won't make sense. Okay, my daughter's come to shut us. Okay, bye, guys.
All right, bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps. Please, we beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
پیش خدمت ہے آپ کی شان میں ہمارے انجمن سے ہائی آئی ایم صدف
اینڈ آئی ایم ارشد کھانے کا اتہاس اکنامکس پالیسی سائیکالوجی سب ہے مینیو پر
اونلی آن دا نان کاری پوڈ کاسٹ ایوری وینسڈے صرف آئی وی ایم پوڈ کاسٹ ایپ یا ویب سائٹ پر یا پھر جہاں سے بھی آپ اپنے پوڈ کاسٹ سنتے ہو
Remember the last vacation you took? What about the one you took 3 years ago? Okay, how much do you really remember? It's a question I've asked myself often over a decade of traveling the world. Hey, I'm Utsav and I do not travel the world for a living. I have a full-time job and responsibilities, but I have made traveling the world a priority. Priority enough that I negotiate extra leave in my job contracts, obsessively track my frequent flyer miles, and I'm willing to take off at the sight of a cheap ticket. Yes, I am cheap. I have lived and worked in 3 countries. I understand human behavior for a living. And these experiences have given me unique insights into places, people, and culture. With over a decade of travel behind me, I increasingly realized one thing, that we cannot see everything. So whatever we see, we must see deeply. Because as the film of memory decays, the imprints which will stand the test of time are the ones felt by the immersion of the senses, not by fleeting encounters with them. Postcards from Nowhere is an immersion into the world of slow travel, one story at a time. Tune in every Thursday on the IVM Podcasts app, website, or wherever you get your podcast from.